Audio levels, check.
All right.
This is Do They Know It's Christmas from 1984. I remember the morning this was released. It was right around Thanksgiving, if I'm not mistaken. And I was watching. I was in high school. I was a sophomore in high school, I think. And I was watching, I used to watch Underdog from 7:30 to 8. And then I'd get to watch Two Woody Woodpeckers from 8 to like 8:20, because school started at 8:48, I think. And I always preferred the Woody Woodpeckers that weren't Woody Woodpeckers. Sometimes they were like Woody Woodpecker cartoons that didn't have Woody. Like the one where the dog or whatever it was like babysitting the house while the bear was in hibernation. And Chili Willy or somebody kept, or some character kept knocking over all the fragile stuff. And I remember the dog caught all the stuff in his arms and legs before it broke. And he had to run out to the, outside the door, out to the distance away from the house on his butt cheeks. That's one of the funniest things I ever saw. Anyway, to the cover. Anyway, but real fast, I remember I'd switched the channel to MTV at the time, and I saw this video. I was like, wow. And it's like a smorgasbord of 80s people. And of course they give Sting the line, the bitter sting of tear. So I guess you had to give Sting. Anyway, if they still accept donations, please do it. I give around, well, anyway, to stuff. You know, you gotta give. So here it is. Phil Collins on drums, I think he got to do one take. And they were like, great. And he was like, alrighty. So here we go. Roll it. Guys, it's coming in. Well, they might be Phil Collins.
It's Christmas time.
Might have been like.
There's no need to be afraid. At Christmas time,
okay.
We let in light and we vanish it. And in our world,
boy,
of plenty, we can spread a smile of joy.
It's coming in now.
For your arms around the world. Christmas time.
Pray for the other one.
At Christmas time.
Bob Geldof, baby. And I think that's like the Boomtown Rats helping him out. Anyway, more videos on the way. Zeppelin-y. I mean, I'm determined to get an actual guitar player down here and the bass player. I'm going to ask Frank from Cashmere to come in with the guitar, and then they have a bass player. They have a couple of bass players, but there's one that's particularly John Paul Jonesy. I'm going to see maybe if I can get him. But I'd like to do it, if I could, on like a... I guess I get it. You might not see him playing. But this... Well, see if they'll do it. You know what I mean? Because it could be publicity for them, too. I mean, I'd give them some dough for coming out, right? I mean, it'd be like, you know... They don't live close. But maybe for like 2 or 3 hours, we could run through like different parts of songs. It'd be instrumental, too. We just have the guitar and the bass. But that's what I've been really shooting for. I'm just kind of slow getting it done. But I think that'd be the best for like Zeppelin demonstration purposes. You know what I mean? Plus, two, what I might do is play along with some Zeppelin covers that aren't allowed with the YouTube thing. But you won't hear the music. So I can say, well, this is Black Dog. And you'll just hear me play the drums. So, I think that's what I'm going to do. I got to tell you. T-shirts. I got the T-shirts coming in. I could probably put... Well, I got to get the logo up so you can see it. But anyway, what it is, it's the bottom three circles, and it says Bonzoleum University on it. That's a little presumptuous, but I couldn't think of what else to put on there. I didn't want to put, like, Bonzoleum drum videos. Well, I don't know. I just thought it'd be kind of funny, Bonzoleum University. Do you know what I mean? So I hope that's not... I don't mean to be egotistical with that, but I just thought it kind of looked cool. And I have the font that's Zeppelin-y. You know what I mean? The shirts are white, and there's a dark blue... It's dark blue writing. And did you know the original Bonham circles, albeit on the bass drum, are like equally spaced like that? Like each space between the circles, each Venn diagram-y where it crosses over, where they share the... Those are like equidistant. On the bass drum. But in the original Led Zeppelin, like, literature or artwork, they're not. There's a bigger... The circle goes further down and not as much here. And that's what my shirt's going to look like. So I hope nobody's like, you know, you got the logo wrong. So I did it the original artwork way. So more videos on the way. Yes, my finger did explode yesterday when I was making that video. I was helping my mom last week with my sister winterize her patio furniture. And I, with the scissors, I sliced the very top of my finger. It kind of opened up like, you know what I mean? And blood, there wasn't as much blood as I thought there'd be. But anyway, yesterday I did smash it between the rim. So, but I'm okay. It wasn't that bad. It didn't rip the whole thing open. But anyway, more videos on the way, like I said. And hopefully I'll get Frank and the bass player out to do this stuff. Thanks for watching my cover. I know it wasn't super tight. But I mean, that's how I'd really play it. I did run through it once because I wanted to make... Darn sure I had the arrangement down, okay? And I know I didn't play it true to the Phil Collins form, but, it is what it is. So, thank you for watching. More videos on the way. Please subscribe if you haven't.